new album out, true, but the two founding members of the band haven't spoken to each other for almost a year, and actually went so far as to record their contributions to the new album quite separate from each other. Confused? You'll be even more so when you receive an earful of their new, and probably last, album, the introspective and very druggy sounding Recurring. We asked the boys, separately of course, for a full rundown of what was really going on in the band. But more than that, we asked for a couple of urine samples. Yes, urine samples. The boys, being gents, cheerfully obliged and will be doubtless further relieved to know their samples have been put in good use in fertilizing certain tropical plants I have in my flat. Rapido investigates, specimen free.
The Spaceman 3 schism went public last year when Jason Pierce launched his spiritualized project and Pete Sonic Boom Kemba released his solo album Spectrum. Here's Jason Pierce on their unusual working methods.
The tracks were pretty much recorded separately anyway, so it seemed kind of okay to do it like that on the album. And I guess we got used to hearing it that way. I think now it would be very hard to compile it as a normal album, as to arrange the tracks so that they were different, like Pete's tracks were on running with my tracks or whatever. I think everybody just got used to hearing it as two sides, so it was put out like that.
Jason Pierce and Sonic Boom entered into unstable joint custody of Spaceman 3 for Recurring, writing and producing one side each, and singing and playing only on their own tracks. Sonic Boom kept certain material for his own work.
See, when I was recording a solo album, the Spectrum album, I had a whole load of songs, including most of the songs from Recurring, and there was a whole lot of sad songs and there was a lot of really up-tempo, quite happy songs, and the sad songs were the older songs, and I felt that I wanted to get those out of the way, so that's why Spectrum was nearly all quite down, quite depressing, sad songs, and I kept what I felt were the better songs, the more up songs for the Spaceman 3 album.
The clash between the duo's egos seems to have been accelerated when Pierce formed Spiritualized, toured extensively and released the 1990 cult single Any Way That You Want Me.
It was so as I could get on the road again. Pete was still doing tracks for Recurring, and it was a long way off Spaceman 3 touring again, so I wanted to do another tour. So initially it was set up as a means to get back on the road.
And then?
And things worked out how they did with Spaceman 3, so it's continuing.
Sonic Boom is now managed by Creation's Alan McGee. While there's been much speculation in the music press over the future of Spaceman 3, according to Sonic, or should that be Mr. Boom, the band is already a thing of the past.
It's finished, you know, it's totally finished. There's been things in the press that said, they even said that this was recorded after we got back together, but it was recorded before the band split, and we really just said we've agreed to differ and that's it, you know. We've both got our lives to get on with, and I think that's it, really. You know, it is very, two very separate things.
Well, I'm sick.
The rock feud has illustrious forebears, McCartney and Lennon, Townsend and Daltrey, now Sonic and Jason. We're told they're still not talking, but are busy with individual projects.
I think it's unfair to carry to carry on as Spaceman 3 because it's some kind of marketable commodity. It's unfair to people buying the records if that's the only reason we're doing it. I don't want to stick with the band purely because it's this kind of company logo that we can sell and make more money from. It seems unfair to do that.
It's good to see that.